Well, round one we are on the play. Definitely would like to play with a slow deck. I don't think we really can keep that one. Don't think we can mulligan this one though, on the other hand. Turn two, Ephemeron. At least backed up by Tribal Flames. Possibly by some three drops if we get there. So we get find out that Stifle is in the format. Well, definitely want an island. Well, a reach dream mist scares me a little bit. Makes me very happy that we have a dampened thought in the sideboard. But it does on the other hand mean that we might well be playing like a blue red mirror where they've got the glacial ray. Alternatively, they could have some kind of scary storm desperate ritual deck. Blight Speaker, on the other hand, makes me feel very happy. If we draw a land, even happier because it means we can electrolyze it. If we don't, definitely going to let it live and make an error into Ephemeron again. And then, of course, we don't, so our entire game. And we can definitely give that Blight Speaker a turn, especially if we do draw a land, and they make another one toughness dude, like a Pestermite or something. We can really get there. Rogues, a number of fairies. Well, that's the second red sort thing that we were wishing for. I think, don't know, Tribal Flames or Logic Knot? I think Logic Knot, because I think we're going to get more value out of. Oh, actually, no, we should have just discarded the Deadeye. We need way more mana for that. That was bad. I think we needed the Tribal Flames in case we miss on the land this turn, in which case we definitely want to kill the Blight Speaker. Don't know what rebels it can find up, but. Well, that's tough. Well, do we want to go for a Plains to turn on the. Turn up the Tribal Flames? Do we want to just Tribal Flames the Blight Speaker? I'm actually happy with our opponent spending his turn shipping in and using the Blight Speaker. Especially as it's likely that he'll find another Blight Speaker. What do we go with here? Well, Molten to Disasters, lots of blue, lots of red, all the double blues, the Traumatic Visions, which find us more land or very expensive. Thundercloud Shaman, yeah. Party Dragon, yeah. Well, that is a few cards. and Molten Disaster, of course. Yeah, I'm gonna risk the planes just to increase our Tribal Flames, which is we have right now. Otherwise, it was kind of even, all things considered. La 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 la. Well, I mean, you know, we've got these ephemerons sticking down, and our opponent isn't exactly. Although they've curved out, it's not exactly super threatening. And we have a electrolyze, which is already semi-dominating the board. It's going to be pretty in our turn if we end up a missile land drop again, because we're going to want to electrolyze to draw land, but we also want to see what he's going to Blight Speaker out. I actually think it's probably more correct to wait to see what he's doing in this manner, especially because it means that the electrolyze will resolve. Which might even be more important at this point in the game than what our first ephemeron resolving. Oh, that's good and bad at the same time. Well, let's tick those babies down. Oh, it doesn't return it to its hand, it just gets cast for cheaper. Well, the Molten Disaster does encourage me to target the Thieving Sprite over the Blight Speaker, but as we can't cast it, and I think Blight Speaker represents, well, does it? What other rogue things are there? There's enough fairies in there that pepper smoke and yeah, I'm actually going to leave the Blight Speaker there for now. Well, now we come to our first ephemeron turn. Shorting boss, shorting. Looks like one of our ephemerons, the first of the ephemerons, is resolving. So, just make sure it really is an earthquake. Yep. Well, I guess that explains the reach through mists as well. The Dreamspell Witches, of course. If we Deadeye, then we're not going to pay the upkeep. Don't really feel that there's in much worry about letting him block the Dreamspell Witches here. Don't really care about paying the echo on the Deadeye. Happy to. I don't think Unsummon is in the set or Vapor Snag or whatever. Because that could be a bit annoying or misdirection or some such. Through miss with no splice. Always a good sign if they're digging. Oh, traumatic vision manner is available, so let's see what happens. No, this one resolves as well. I do, of course, have no intention or ability to pay the echo on this guy. Well, now we do, but well, there is disco out there. Might keep it in the hand for now. Pre-combat. Don't know what. Tappy thing. What? He just did nothing, right? Cool. Perfectly happy with him wasting the mana. Almost made me misclick through the attack. We can tribal flames him down to. I'm in no rush right now. I'll make the island so that we can mold and disaster for more. I don't feel like we need to worry about killing Blight Speaker or with either of our spells, especially with him at 8 and when 1 mana away from these spells being lethal on our hands, forget about our currently lethal dragons. Toilbless sacrifices a creature. If it's a goblin, get some 1/1s. Well, okay. I'm imagining there's not a second where that came from, at least not this turn. Which means one mountain away from being uncounterably lethal. Well, that puts Errant Ephemeron in Pepper Smoke block range, so definitely going to kill that pre. Whoop, definitely going to bounce that pre combat. Swing a ding down to 4 with 2 lethal creatures on the play. He didn't respond to the bounce by pepper smoking. Might well have been right if he had it. Well, certainly, it looks very right if he had it because that would have put him to 5, which means they're not lethal, and allowed him to dig for a card, be it another Warren's Pilf, Warren's Weirding, or whatever. Back comes the latchkey. And Son of Una. Well, that does look like this molten disaster will kill you. What's the best way to do it? Attack, attack. They trade. Whatever, let's just kill him. Maybe we get dazed here, is that in the set? I don't know. Cool. Well, couldn't really. I mean, we were winning that game, so it looked very good, but we couldn't really ask for a match where our electrolyzers will do better. Petals will be tempting in this kind of matchup. These fairy macabres, fairy mechanists, might be what the doctor ordered, though. Even 1, 2, 3, 4. They only have 4 targets as is. Don't really see too much value in moving the white. If we brought them both in, I would move to the black splash. The Deadeye is fine. The Shaman doesn't look phenomenal in this matchup, I won't lie. But that being said, I like the deck as it is.